What a cat. Everyone, gotta come on me back up because my studio's not come back up the other one yet. So I've got to do it this way. I'm afraid. You can just tap and share for me while we get going. Thank you. Morning, Observer. How are you? Need to share it out for me, guys, because it's not my usual account, obviously. So, thank you. Morning, Lou. Hey, up, Max. Chunky, good morning. He's absolutely throwing it down. Come on, he builds it. Oh, we need to get people in. But we haven't got 19 of us. morning. Nisi. Good morning. Morning, Michelle. Got a feeling I'll see you later. Robbo, thank you. Ash, Andy, Mills, and Lou, Crayon, Robbo, Charmaine. Enjoy this song. Old age, aye, it is us. I know, these older songs just remind you of certain things, don't they? I know, exactly what I was doing when this came out.
Just don't know, I just don't care.
Toodles. Alright. We're done with that. Alright, so, first off, we'll kick off with part one of the story about the wolf, the gifting, the accusations, the Claire, and all this. So there's three parts to this. Let's have a look at this.
One day went on. 2 days went on.
I take it he's one of the Australians with the accent.
And guess what? I'm receiving irrelevant fucking messages from Claire.
So this is all about Wolf's gifter, isn't it? Claire was his biggest gifter. She's ploughed thousands of pounds into the Wolf and other people.
Photos that I didn't want to see. I'm sure you guys understand what I'm trying to say.
You know what it reminds me of, actually? Just thinking about it. Have you seen them daft Australians? Millions, I heard. Millions, wow.
I'm trying to defend a lot of people on this app.
Australians on YouTube that do all the daft stories.
Just put that in mind. Alright, yeah. Moving forward, she gifted me for a reason, and she wanted things over the phone, this and that. I'm sure you guys can put it all together. I said to myself, no, fuck that. I blocked her. You don't gift somebody expecting something in return.
I don't know about you lot, but I don't understand anybody ploughing millions into somebody on TikTok. You know, I mean, there's far better causes out there, isn't there?
Turn something? I don't want to get bananaed, right? I don't want to get banned. But there was an expectation, all right, for why this person not just gifted me, but gifted multiple people. Miss Abbeckett, moving forward, 5 streamers have fallen victim to this person. 5 streamers. Five streamers have fallen victim to this person. Mind you, the photos that she's sending out about herself, it's not her. She is using somebody else's photo. I don't know if she's embarrassed about what she looks like, but she's kind of catfishing people.
They say fallen victim. They weren't playing victim whilst taking the money. Exactly, you know what I mean? I mean, I've got a question. Has she run out of money or said, I'm not giving you any more money, and suddenly they've turned on her? That I'm, you know what I mean? There's lots of questions going on in my head.
Well, with an image from Google saying that that's me.
Morning, Missy.
You want to say that again? And I'm going to put the photos on.
Thanks for the heart meets, guys, by the way.
She is targeting men. She's supporting him and going, hey, guys, this is me.
Morning, Chris.
To manipulate. It's not a matter of helping everyone. She is now targeting a lot of people who had her back. She's now targeting...
Well, can I ask you a question, right? Do you think these lot are scared of something that might come out? That she's got something and they're sort of like... People are starting to go at her just to try and shut her down before she does something that they're not going to like, really like.
A lot of people that had her back. I'm not all good with Holmes, I'm very sorry, but... But what I see, I'm a person. I was trying to...
Fucking embarrassing.
Wrong one, Holmes, part two.
I'm like, woof. Everybody, I fucking warned and warned as well. Wait, hold on. It gets better.
Yeah, me drillers.
It gets better. This is how untrustworthy and how this woman betrays everything.
Right, hold on a minute. He just said she was untrustworthy. She's ploughed millions into these people, according to estimations. She's ploughed millions into these people, but yet she's untrustworthy. Jesus Christ, seriously, get your heads into a grip, mate.
Everybody, listen to this. The day where the messages happened between me and Claire, okay? There was a conversation over the phone.
It just screams, does it not scream to you? The summit that they just don't want coming out?
Yeah, Chicks, wait. There was a conversation over the phone between me and Claire. She made a promise to me. Claire made a promise to me. She told me that she will support Holmes. But if I am on the podium, if my team pushes me on the podium, I'm about words, bro. I'm about loyalty. If somebody tells me something, it should go. Put your money where your mouth is, right? She saw.
Put your money. We had an understanding. Put your money. Put your money where your mouth is, but yet you're slagging her off. Shouting and clap. Because I think they're trying to shut her down. There's something she's got that they know she's got, and they want to shut down. I think this is all about slagging her off enough to shut her down.
I won't push you off the podium, I promise. They're her words, I swear to God.
She asked for her money back.
On my mother's eyes, yeah? And my mum drops
dead. Is that what they're panicking about?
She told me, if you're on the podium, I won't push Holmes over you. No worries, thank you.
Oh, so she pushed one, and then she's gone over and pushed another one. Fucking.
One. Happened once. All right, no worries. Twice. No worries. Three times. No worries.
Fucking hell, Shami. He wanted to dip his noodle. I don't want soup at your house.
Five times, six times. All right, no worries. I gave her a call. I'm like, Claire, you're a fucking liar. You're not a woman of your fucking word. And there it happens. A heated argument happened. Claire told me, I hope you lose your son over the phone. I'm not somebody that records, bro. On an oath on God, she goes, I hope you lose your son. You are not a good father. You are not. They're the words that came out of Claire's mouth. That triggered me.
Thanks, Esther Sunshine.
That triggered me.
Juicy. Lucy.
That triggered me, bro.
Juicy Lucy.
I got upset. I said to myself, fuck, this lady just had a dig at me and my boy, bro. Cerulean, this lady just had a dig at me and my fucking boy. She just said...
If you watch his eyes, he's having to think about what is, you know what I mean? This is just not something Runoff is thinking this. It's all premeditated. He's premeditating in his head before he says it. I'm telling you now. You watch his eyes.
Because I was speaking the truth, I hope you lose your son, bro. Who the fuck says that shit? I got triggered. I messaged them back with a photo of the son, and I said, yeah, well, I'm going to fucking expose you, and I'm going to fucking expose your son. Meanwhile, I didn't even know what she looked like. I didn't know what she looked like. Moving forward, she's gone on live a couple of times to degrade me and say, that I'm a violent person, that I threatened her, but what did you do to poke the bear?
Stop getting angry, mate.
To get a reaction from Paula is the question, Claire.
He already admitted that he lost his rag, so...
Is the question, what did you do to provoke Paula? Why don't you open up and tell everyone the truth?
Morning, Larry.
What did you do to poke the bear to get a reaction out of Paula?
Poke the fucking bear. Who do you think you are? Fucking hell. Big paw, little paw.
Now she's going online.
Fuck me, seriously. These fucking people on here.
And manipulating and victim playing. Why?
Yeah. You notice when the level 40 came in, is in there. Look, can you see the level 40 tag? The level 40 tag came in. Look how close he is at that screen. Who's that? Ooh, level 40.
She's coming on the app. We dealt with it off the app. King Holmes is a witness. King Holmes, can you write something in the chat?
What's this King Holmes? Ohms. I thought that were like a measurement of electricity or something.
And we deal.
Morning, Sarah. How are you, love?
She decided to crawl on the app and cause drastic drama because she loves the clout. She loves the attention. She loves the victim playing. Okay. I'm not done yet.
Well, isn't that what you're doing? Isn't that what he's doing? Victiming himself by ranting and raving over a gifter. Gifting somebody else.
Now, I don't know how many people have fallen victim to this person.
Fucking victim.
But if you're going to poke the bear...
Roar!
You're going to get a reaction out of Paulo now. Claire is not innocent.
I think he does. He says he's not angry, but you know what I mean? So far.
Nor are any of us fucking streamers innocent. Cerulean, welcome. Just listen to what I'm like trying to say.
There is noodles. Coffee time.
All right. No one's innocent. And that's the fucking truth. That's the truth. No one's innocent. You cannot, as a human being, sit on a social media platform. I don't know what you really look like. And you're going around catfishing men.
Catfishing men.
You're a big gifter on this app. You're a level 50. Yet you're going around giving people false hope.
Morning, Quinn.
Giving people false hope.
Morning, Trace. False hope. So he's mad because... Do you know? Because he pushed somebody else. She pushed somebody else with the money. And he didn't get where he wanted to be. Fucking shut up. Seriously. Get a grip of your life.
Of course I'll protect you. My people I'll protect at all costs. My people, the people who stand by me... Everybody in my chat will be protected by me at all costs.
Poor little Max.
You feel me?
Fuck you.
Now!
I can't take this guy seriously.
Now, it is not fair.
You watch him in Monzo. Who's Monzo?
That people are creating.
Stop. Yeah. Go stand up the street with a tin.
Oh dear. Unnecessary drama for their own benefit on this app. Bro, when you gift somebody, no one tells you. No one forces your head onto the fucking...
Put a puffer. I know, why has he got a puffer jacket? Do you know, I never even picked a puffer jacket. I'm going to put some big claws on, but I look big then.
To the phone and say, gift me, bro. No one. You're responsible for what you fucking do. Am I wrong or right? You're responsible...
You're all responsible. When somebody's gifting you, you're responsible for making sure, if they're gifting you big, and I mean big money, you should always be asking them if they're okay with it, and if you feel uncomfortable with it, you should be blocking them, so they can't gift you. So yeah, you have to take responsibility yourselves as well.
On what you do on your own fucking device. Correct me if I'm wrong.
I just did.
But one thing I find is people gift, they don't get what they want, and they become an enemy.
I think you've made her an enemy. An enemy. Everyone's definition of big is, of course it is, Charmaine, but do you know what? So for somebody out of work, a fiver's big money. For somebody in work, a fiver can still be big money. But somebody who's got millions of pounds to throw away, it may be, it's nothing to him, but it's still to you, it's still big money. Do you know what I mean? Guy needs to chill.
They become an enemy, bro, why?
Hold on a minute. On my screen, just reminding everybody, I don't see any tapping going on. You know? Nothing. Not one.
Why? Because I didn't like
something. You know what I mean? Don't poke the bear. Don't poke the bear. Get the fucking taps in. Come on, fucking hell.
Something you've done. They didn't like something you've done.
Don't like what? It? Fucking hell. Picking up somebody else, but you're not picking up my taps. Come on. Don't poke the bear.
You went out and hung with somebody you don't like. What, they want to turn on you? Now!
Yeah, if you don't want a noodle pick, get tapping.
This has to be said. I love you all, but this has to be said.
My sister sits with a lot of Australians, and they're all nice people, honestly, but yeah, some of them do get loud, don't they?
This has to be done.
We're in the army now.
And I'm not doing this because I want to do it. I'm doing it for the people.
He's doing fucking hell. He's going for presidency in the United States. Do it for the people.
Where are these photos?
Fucking hell.
Mrs. Claire Connolly, this is who you claim you are.
Right, so this is what she's supposed to look like. Okay. Yeah, not wrong with that.
Okay.
Yeah, and?
Mrs. Claire Connolly, this is who you claim you are.
Yeah, okay.
This is the photo that you're sending to every guy you gift.
Okay. Maybe she wants to hide her identity.
This is you, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's you, isn't it?
Yeah.
Mind you, you've met Wolf, you've met Sam, you've met a lot of people.
Yeah.
This is a photo, and these are the images you're using.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah.
You're using.
Yeah.
To catfish people, correct?
Yeah.
Wait, it gets better.
All right, cool. Someone's putting in, it's that's not her. Come on. I'm dying to meet her. Come on.
Two different people, Claire.
And? Maybe she had her hair done before.
two different people. You can't buy men on this app thinking you can go and victimise people. No, that's not funny, bro.
It makes me laugh, right? Looks the same. Probably that the first picture was her dressed up, going out, going to a wedding or something. That's maybe just as she is. And the point?
It's not funny. It's not funny.
That's not catfishing. I can tell you from experience, my ex-wife, for example, she didn't wear makeup every day and all that sort of stuff, but when she got dressed up, looks totally different when she gets dressed up. Absolutely different.
Against that shit. I'm against that shit. That's her.
I know, I thought he was going to like produce like a hobbit or something, you know what I mean? Yeah, a lot of women don't wear. A lot of women will just, you know, a lot of women will get up in the morning, get makeup up, dressed up, go to work looking like they're going out, you know what I mean, sort of thing, because they take pride in themselves or whatever. Some women are just don't want to do that and will love to get dressed up when they're doing something special. The man's affected over no makeup, yeah.
Oh, no, Claire!
Is that what he's upset about, really? Do you think he had a picture in his head and he fancied her and then suddenly he's disappointed? What a sad twat.
Oh, no! Maybe be very careful how you fucking play the app, yeah?
But why is he going after the looks anyway? You know what I mean? What's the looks got to do with what she's, you know, what money she's handed out and stuff? What's it got to do with that?
Be very fucking wary how you
Yeah, but he didn't hurt you. Exactly. Exactly, Ninja.
Be very fucking wary.
She could have been a 2-foot dwarf with the biggest feet in history, a beard, big ears, and he wouldn't have cared while she were throwing money at him. That wouldn't have been a problem. Morning, Alison.
It is not funny. It is not funny, man.
He's just trying to humiliate her.
A lot of people have fallen victim to this lady. She only gifts for an agenda.
She gifts for an agenda. But you accepted that agenda when you accepted the gifts. Without question. Yeah.
Yeah, that's her. That's her, bro. That's her, brother. On God, it's her. Now wake up to yourselves. Arms, wake up to yourself, brother.
What's this arms? Arms, what does that mean? It's a tosser, isn't it? Look, you can see by his behaviour, his anger, the way he's trying to humiliate her looks, her whole thing about her. He's, you know, he didn't give a shit when he was taking the money. Now he gives a shit. Probably because he had a picture in his head, liked the first picture, and now he doesn't like the second picture. It's just fucking shallow bullshit, isn't it?
This is not somebody...
Well, I think my conclusion from that is you embarrassed yourself, pal. Absolutely.
Fucking embarrassing.
Oh, here's another one. Here's another one. Oh, so Corey, this is late last night, I do believe. Corey was sat in his rented accommodation. crapping his pants because Candyman... Our hunting team was on the way round to his house.
So I know his name, I know police. His address, I know everything about him, don't worry.
He's on the...
Who is this? The guy who done the exposure on the yesterday?
Hi, good evening. I don't really know about what I'm reporting, but I think I more wanted logged more than anything. There's a gentleman online...
Nan Bastis, fuck yeah. I mean, what is that fucking fleece he's wearing? You're complaining about my vest. What the fuck is that thing he's wearing?
Which has followed me on TikTok. He done like a big expose on me yesterday. It was so bizarre. I got a big following on TikTok anyway, right? So
who gives a shit?
He done this expose on me. It was all.
I'm on forward to police. I'm just going to mention I got a big following on TikTok. What a
shit, he just said that I rented I rented my house and stuff. It was all crap. But they...
Like bullies. Oh, he said I rented my house. It's a load of crap. Fuck off, you tosser.
Basically, right, he comes from a background of, like, being a paedophile hunter. So what he's done is he called one of my friends and said that he was on his way down to my house. He lives in Crewe. So he was on his way down to my house. I live in Mountain Ash. So he said that he was on his way down here to sting me.
That fucking top's definitely been on a Mountain's Ash.
And then the woman said back to him, well, obviously you haven't done anything wrong, so why are you going down there?
This is a good example of wasting police time. Nothing's happened. There's no signs of anything happening. It's just somebody said something, you know what I mean? The big man, the behind the screen, that can act all big and hard with his big mouth, is shitting his pants, sat in his house, looking through his curtains, because somebody threatened him. Yeah, it says a lot, doesn't it?
Then he said, oh no, I am on my way down there, I'm going to go down there now, right? So that's just that. So then what she done was she gave me his number. So what I done then was I tried to call him, but obviously yeah, it was just a WhatsApp number, right? So I added him on WhatsApp, and then I literally said to him, I said, Jonathan, exactly. Like, what are you doing?
Why? He can fucking give it out, but at the minute somebody brings something to his fucking, threatens to bring something to his door, he's shitting like a shiting dog.
Why are you coming down here, whatever? And then he said, oh my God, you're talking to a 14-year-old boy. Oh my God. I was like, what the fuck? So yeah, so this guy, right, is absolutely obsessed with me. He's put videos of my house online. He's put videos of, like, where I live, what car I drive.
Well, you could hear someone in the background talking, so I take it he is. Got to take it that he is.
He done all of this yesterday. He said how much I pay in rent. And then now apparently he's on his way down my house. apparently so.
I still have a talking clock.
I've only got a WhatsApp number, though. Pardon? My address, give me 2 seconds, bear with.
We know your address. It were exposed the night before. We know it. Oh. It's number 10, Mountain Ash.
But I kept everything anyway.
You know, it's threats and slander, so...
And obviously he's planning on turning up here and making a ruckus, do you know what I mean?
And obviously if he's saying he's bringing 2 men, it's threats. Has he said what he's going to do when he comes?
I don't know. I'm assuming he's probably going to make it out as if I'm some sort of nonce, do you know what I mean? Which obviously I'm not.
Right, no.
So as you can see, guys, I have absolutely nothing to hide. The police will...
Do you know what? I actually think he has something to hide. I think that's why he's actually shitting himself. It was apparently... Somebody was saying they were going to come out with something. What it? Zach was saying he had some stuff on him last night. And apparently, he turned pale and started panicking. So, I think this little deviant little wannabe fucking superstar does have something to hide. I reckon he's got some ghosts in that closet. Some skeletons.
Something. They have to, because that guy's not coming anywhere near me. If he thinks I'm going to open my door, he's going to...
And where the fuck are them eyebrows going? They're wider than his face.
You did. But well done, Pearl. But don't worry, Pearl, I can prove that you're friends with a 15-year-old. Fucking wrong'un.
Big up, Cora. Well done, Pearl Crew. Well said.
It's all come from Pearl, this did. Just because I left my phone on speaker.
Morning, Mary.
Strange. Who's coming for you? That guy who tried to out me last night. Why did you go out and face them? No. Absolutely not. But basically, right, I was we do battles on TikTok. I got told that I needed to call this other creator.
Is this a conversation you have with the fucking police? The conversation don't sound right.
And then obviously she didn't answer the phone, but it went through to voicemail.
Yeah.
So because it was on speaker at the time, obviously it read out.
I haven't got it now, Alison, but yeah, I were richer than him. I owned my own home. With a lot more than he's fucking got. Imagine going... Yeah, I don't agree with it. I don't agree to going into anybody's house, but... I'm just laughing at the way he's shitting his pants. He's such a big man. Why is he shitting his pants?
The number, I didn't think...
Don't give it out if you can't fucking take it.
...think at the time. So essentially, I doxed her then, should we say. So obviously, not everyone... heard the number. I've got a screen recorder that I'll show the officer when he arrives. So you can't really hear the full number, but obviously she jumped on that like a rat up a drain pipe and just made it look as if like I had doxed her on purpose.
I'm on in Whispers.
Then what she done then that night.
Yeah, Whispers, this is provided by Whispers. I do thank everybody, Whispers, here with the, you can see it going across the screen. Too many people to mention individual all the time, you know. But yeah, good morning.
Was she gave my number out to a 15-year-old and an older woman. So the 15-year-old ran me with a bunch of homophobic abuse. Don't worry, I've recorded it all, you've got it all. So once he rang me, I thought he was somebody's husband because she had somebody in the box with the same surname.
I'll make it bigger tomorrow.
So I thought it was her husband, because obviously it was a man's voice, wasn't it? It was a boy's voice, whatever. So when I was talking to him on WhatsApp, which again was very brief, he was just more ringing me more than messaging. But again, I've got your number on. I've got this all recorded for you. So then when he done that...
Exactly, Lucy. This is what I'm saying. He's over-explaining everything. He's going into so much detail about his TikTok life and whatever else. I think this is bullshit. The more I listen to it, I think it's just... Or that operator just doesn't know how to deal with him. I don't know what it is.
Well, when that happened then, that other creator then went across the app then saying I was messaging 15-year-olds and she didn't know who I was messaging and all this palaver.
It's like he's trying to... is trying to get out the conversation about this underage moderator or whatever it was, or contact he had with somebody underage, and sort of justifying that it's not a problem. Do you know what I mean? Trying to get rid of the problem. Do you know what I'm trying to say? I don't know how to put it properly. So it's like he's trying to get it out of the way so nobody can come at him for it.
But then she proved the fact that this 15-year-old was
here. Oh, said it's fine.
And so obviously that's how they got my number. So obviously that was all done then, that was the end of that. But then essentially, you know, after yesterday, after yesterday, this is where it all came from. That guy done an exposure on me for renting a property. And now today now he's trying to make it out as if I'd be messaging these.
I couldn't sleep with his voice in fucking background. I'd have to have my eye open. Sorry, I'd be frightened someone's going to attack me.
These people, but yes,
next. This all sort of come from, he wasn't ever anything to do with it, it was just on it.
Yeah, he's just jumped on it. Yeah, at the end of the day, okay. As I would call them, cloud chaser. Right, there we go. And just to prove the fact that he tried to decoy me, his life is not going to be great after me. So
more than annoying.
The person, right? So this guy, right, called my friend on WhatsApp and told me that he was going to turn up to my house. And then, look at this, look at him on WhatsApp now, right? Hold on, let me just save. So basically, bear this in mind. So as you can see, right, he's got his page with the photo, right? Then he's got the number and everything else. Thank you, Abby, for subscribing, right? And he rung her and said, I'm on my way down Corey's, I'm going to go nuts on him and all this crap, right? Then, when I WhatsApp him to say, I'll see you in a bit, Jonathan. Then he pretends, right? Then he pretends... that he's 14 years old, and then gets one of his friends to say this.
What the fuck are you messaging my 14-year-old son for? You fucking dirty.
Fucking embarrassing. I know his name. And the block.
It really is like he's trying to put it out there, justify it, get somebody to say it's not a problem, and then nobody can come at him for him. That's just.
Thickens, says Miss Faye. Miss Faye, you don't want me to go behind your black curtain, darling?
No.
How did morning, he end?
Casey.
Now, if anyone knows the registration, morning, plate, just birdie. Go on ismycartaxed.gov, put his registration in, and there you go. The private plate is still attached to his old car.
And it is still attached to my old car, and the reason why it's still attached to my old car is because I don't want the number plate anymore, darling. Land registry says you don't own a property. Okay.
He's doxed. It's docked all the man's details like, well, it should be done for doxing then, shouldn't it?
Okay, Bonnie, would you like to come up and show me the
why
proof?
Why does he think he can scare Bonnie? This guy? Are you on about Corey scaring? As a man, I've seen scarier spiders. I swear to God, this man does not scare any fucking grown man. Jesus.
Bonnie?
Anything to you?
Anyway, is that it? I think that's it. Yeah, that's it. So...
he's a gobby little shit. He's definitely a gobby little shit. and it's the type of gobby little shit. You know when you go, when you're driving along a road and someone's road raging you, and the minute you confront them, they just sit there and they won't look at you or anything, and they're sat with both hands on the steering wheel shitting themselves because you've now confronted them. That's the sort of guy he is. A mouthy twat, but as soon as anybody were to confront him or stand in front of him, this man, he'd fold like I don't know what.
Let's start to divulge fold. Everything that he said. So,
definite keyboard warrior.
This is a rental property.
There's a video of him doing that and driving off. Yeah, there you go, you see. Honestly, you can read him like a book. He's a mouthy little shit. He hides behind people. He'd, you know, if you're with his friends, he's one of them. If you're in a pub and he's with a bunch of friends, he's the one that'd be gobbing it all off and then push himself to the back so his mates can deal with it. He's a prop, yeah, fold like a deck chair. He's a proper little wussy.
Well, by games wussy. Well,
and I did say wussy.
In regard, company's house also says you're broke until you file your accounts. Oh, absolutely, Siblings Kitchen. You don't think I'm dumb? Have you had a look at the other creators' business on TikTok? Have you had a look at any of their registered companies? Have you?
Yeah, I look at people's. When they claim they've got a lot of money, I have a look on Company's House to see what they're on about. Yours is a pile of shite, mate.
Have you run your own company before? Have you put everything through the books? Do you declare everything? Because all the big creators on the app don't. Miss Red don't. Evil Queen doesn't. Zach the Twat doesn't. Bill doesn't.
Oh, they will do.
She does. And just to prove my point, is go on to Company's House, type in these creators, and there's one in particular that's on there. One.
Yeah, it does. There's one creator. It does rely on his dad a lot.
Go on there. You know how much he makes because you see it on the rankings. Go on there, right, and see how much he declared last year. See how much he declared on his P60 last year. Go and have a look. Because he made 20,000, right? He made 20,000 in a week. And you tell me how he only made 35,000 in a year.
What you person would wear that jumper? I just don't know. Honestly, the fucking jumper. He's got a Range Rover. I hope he don't jump in a Range Rover dressed like that, I swear to God. If I were a policeman, I'd arrest him every time I saw him going down the road dressed like that.
Yeah, how much he makes. You've all seen it. But you're all just concentrating on me. Oh, it's quite cute. Anyway, so, in regards to me driving up to Liverpool, Warrington to be precise, that was all true. Now, he says, I do not drive a Range Rover. I will take you outside now with my car key, and I will jump in my car, and I will show you my new car.
People that go out here.
Anyway, so this is the vehicle. This is my car. As you can see, Land Rover, Range Rover. Okay,
five. Probably PCP released, whatever it is. Probably never paid a penny out, as in he owns it. He probably has to hand that back every 3 years or whatever it is.
Yes, got a lovely roof and all the rest of it. Happy, happiest, there we go.
Or he does it through the company, you know what I mean? Does it through the company, etc. So it'll be a company car, tax purposes and all that. It'll be classed as a company car and it'll be bloody, what do you call it? It'll be on lease, so.
In regards to the business, not making any money. Can't believe I got to prove this. So let's go on to.
So again, he doesn't own it. It's not something he owns. He might own the number plate that he's now got rid of because he couldn't afford it.
On my phone, actually, making it easier.
He's already said it's PCP.
So let me
log into
my business account, Fabulous. Let me go on here and type in statements.
Financed.
Let's
go on, God, you're one step ahead of me, you lot, this morning, aren't you?
Wild Marks Unlimited, that's me, by the way, Fabulous.
I don't watch the Pratt, so I have him blocked, so.
We'll do the last 3 months.
Can't stand him.
Give me 2 seconds, just write the statement for me now. Marvellous. So in regards to me being broke, let me just go on the...
Yeah, you'd have to put a deposit, so on a lot of these PCPs, you put a deposit down, you put a, whatever percentage it is, you put a deposit down, which, again, you can put more down as well, and it lowers the amount of PCP that, you know, the amount you're paying every month. And then after so long, you hand it back, get a new one, whatever. So, yeah. Again, it just shows you that he's not actually got the money in, you know, he hasn't paid 50, 60, 70 grand out for a car. It's not his. He doesn't own it.
Look, I got paid 5 grand on Friday, just gone. Oh, what a shame. Anyway, So my company has made £46,680 dead on in the last 4 months, from July to October the 8th.
Is that... So when he's showing this, that it's made, his company made £46,000, is that after he's paid everything out? Is that a net take? Is it net, gross, net, whatever it is? Is that the final amount? It's fucking boring. Does my head in.
There it is. Okay? Fabulous. Am I bothered by you seeing that?
Thanks,
no.
Liz.
Have I got multiple bank accounts? Yes. Do I pick and choose what I put on my fucking P60s? Yes.
I could check it in Boxy if I were that bothered, yeah.
Yes. Does the account have access to my current bank account? Yes. I'm not stupid. I run a business, darling. We all run businesses. Go on Company's House right now. Search up that particular creator, which is always, 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 always on the dailies. Go and have a look. And tell me how he only made £30,000 last year, when I've seen him make 20 grand in a week.
Boring bastard. Hmm. Oh, talking of boring bastards. Sorry. I didn't mean to do that, but yeah, talking of boring bastards.
Harry Ring. Nix, thank you.
The fuck is that plastic round his neck? Wild! Look at the fucking plastic round. Plastic gold.
I'm doing Club Tropicana special.
Halloween. Oh, well, we can't fucking wait, really.
Special. When I have left the agency fully on my main account, Club Tropicana can carry on, what, 50-50...
What? I don't get that. Why does it matter if he's left the agency or not to do this?
He split with this account.
The guy's full
so
of
I'll
shit.
So I do Club Tropicana earlier on in the evening, and then later on in the evening, I'll come on this account.
Can we put times 2 on?
I will not be putting any...
It's not that long a video, trust me.
He's in a pot for
an
agency.
Dressed as a beastie boy.
enables such behaviour.
Teemu, it's the worst of the team. Even Teemu wouldn't sell that shit. When he takes it, he holds it in his hand at some point. Fucking, you can hear it. It's like foil. Fucking. Okay. Like tin foil.
I'm quite.
Trigger warning! I'll be back in a second.
I'm quite flattered that I'm the talk of TikTok, I'm not gonna lie. It's actually quite flattering. I've actually affected the whole TikTok. Yeah. I think I deserve a fucking medal. Even Evil Queen couldn't affect TikTok as to how I've affected TikTok. Even I have affected Evil Queen. I've even affected her. Has she read my message out yet on her live? I'm a genius. Taurine is vile tonight. Sam watched you now for years. We still don't chat. Hi, Sam. I don't know.
By the way, if anybody's on a subject we're talking about, if you want to jump in the box and quickly talk about it, you can do. Okay?
You are?
It's not a problem.
Let's have a look at Taurine. Let's, so I've taken off screen recording of Frankie, because that's going to the police.
Give me 2 seconds, French.
Hello, mate.
All right, pal. Just give me 2 secs. I'll put headphones in. It's better that way.
Oh, can you hear me all right?
Yeah, I'm good, thank you. Yeah, no, she's a local bike. Or not meaning like a TikTok bike. She's an alcoholic. She abuses her mother. Her mother's actually at the moment in hospital. She spends her time on this TikTok. If that was my mother, I'd be off TikTok and I'd be looking after my mother.
Yeah, I think most people agree with
she's
you that
she's an absolute wrong one. She needs to be taken off the app. She needs to be detoxed bad because her liver's probably got cirrhosis.
Yeah,
it's disgusting. She's an absolute tramp.
Yeah, I mean, I've tried to see some good in her at points, but I've given up on her. Absolutely given up on her.
Oh no, and her little buddy Linz as well encourages this sort of enabling behaviour.
Yeah, Linz is a nobody, isn't she? She's an absolute nobody. She's one of the most...
Yeah, absolute nobodies. They like bum lick each other, really. And then they fall out, then they're back again.
Yeah, they do.
Not being funny, Lynn's be the next one that will being like Angie, be drinking.
No, I think Lynn's... I mean, there's this thing about... Oh, is this Arsenal? Are you Arsenal? Are you Arsenal?
No, I'm not Arsenal.
No?
No, I'm not Arsenal. I'm Jodie.
I'm sorry. You don't sound like Arsenal. I remember Arsenal.
Yeah, no. I'm a Man City fan.
You're a Man City fan?
Yeah. I've got to go anyway because I've got to go to work.
All right, love. Okay. All right. Thanks for popping in.
All right, much thanks. Love.
Right. Bye-bye. Shabby, good morning.
Good morning.
How are you?
I was just jumping up to talk about the subjects you have played.
Yeah.
I think it would be nice if Karma Kaz went back to doing his... I mean, I know people, you either like him or you don't. It would be nice for him to go back to doing his dissecting of people. And I've seen him do a live whereby he was helping people to up their websites and things, you know, for their personal businesses.
Yeah,
we like to see him go back to doing that because he is, like him or not, he is really good at doing things like that.
I think the problem is that it's not who he is. It was even self-admitting he didn't get it right and he were out of his depth. And I think that he tried something, didn't work. It wasn't really him. I think what we've seen now is really him. It's you know, I've known him for 4 years and I think this is. Actually, who he really is. I think he's just shown his true colours. To be fair.
We're just nice to not have everyone that was like that, you know?
Yeah, that's why we're so disappointed in him, because we perceived him as a different person and then he turned out to be exactly opposite of what he said he was. But I think what you see now is exactly who he wants to be because that's who he is. So I think the rest of it's all just bullshit for the app.
So. And then jump back to the Australian,
Abrae.
So what I'm getting from that is he's upset because someone stopped gifting him. When are these self-entitled, self-important people going to get it? It's not your money. People will gift who they want to gift. Don't like it. Tough tackies.
Yeah. The all I get from what I heard from there was that they don't like the fact that she was gifting other people when she'd promised to gift them, push them up a leaderboard. So she was okay right up until that minute of them saying, well, I'll push you as an individual up a leaderboard. I'll get you to number one. So they're, oh, yeah, I'm great. I'm fine with that. You're great. You're the best. Get your gifts to me. The minute she's then going to push somebody else, it's a big fucking deal. So it is about the money. It's just about pure fucking greed, innit? I think it's them that are a selfish bunch of twats. To be honest. Go on.
I was going to say, it's getting to the point, I mean, you hear it so often these days, everyone's arguing over, oh, so-and-so's gifted so-and-so, it's none of your damn business who's gifting who. Get a life. You're not making enough money, get a damn job.
Yeah, it's nobody's business who's gifting who. I think the only thing that people do concern about is are people over-gifting. Do you know, if someone seems to be putting a lot of money over, I think you've got a right or a duty as an individual that's receiving that money to ask if they're okay with, because we know how the manipulation works on here, how people sort of get into trouble. So I think people do have a duty to ask, are you okay with that amount of money that you're handing over?
And I agree with that, right? But what I have a problem with is these people are all happy when they're the ones getting gifted loads.
Mm-hmm.
But when someone else get gifted loads, oh, they're manipulating them.
Yeah.
Oh, they're taking all their money.
Well, he in them videos, all he was doing was attacking her personality, attacking her her intentions, and attacking her looks. Three main factors about her. Putting her down. Humiliating her.
And so this is the thing with people that gift. You know, you're gifting these people, and you're right whilst you're gifting. As soon as you don't,
mm-hmm.
look what happens.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Absolutely. So, Yeah, on Corey.
I'm going to wait till you've played all the videos, because I think we've got some videos that will tie into it. I don't want to speak too much about Corey.
Yeah, I know.
I think he's a knob, but he actually was I saw a little bit of what he was doing last night, and he actually seemed to be all right. But that Milan...
Oh, Milan, no, yeah. I'm just saving up for Milan.
Yeah.
Milan's going to need a lot of videos doing. Milan needs keeping an eye on Milan's. Yeah.
To me, he just appears to be wanting to be like everyone else, an absolute felon.
Mm-hmm. Milan's big clout chasing at the moment, but Milan's saying a lot and doing a lot that he shouldn't be doing. So I'm keeping my eye on Milan.
I don't think he actually feels that way. I think he's just trying to say things to get controversy.
Well, isn't that what a lot of them do? But they're all, yeah. I don't like what comes out of Milan's mouth a lot of the time, so I think he's a snidey little fucker, so to put it mildly. I didn't want to say that too loud. Robbo.
Hiya.
Oh, you are here.
I just want to say, yes, I am here. I just want to say about Corey with us keeping on about Company's House.
Mm-hmm.
It's because he's a limited company. Sole traders, partnership businesses are not on Company's House. Also, with his tax returns that is available to be seen, he ain't actually earning that money because he hasn't really hit the tax threshold for VAT.
Yeah.
So this bloke is only earning... I say only, but it's about 85 grand.
Yeah, it's not a lot of money, saying, is it?
So he's saying he's earned like 40-something thousand or whatever the last couple of months is a load of rubbish.
Yeah.
His profit. So all this spouting off all the time is a load of cow and rubbish.
I think that's what I'm trying to say. Is it profit? So when a company shows... what's his profit and what's his outgoings, what's his income in, is
exactly.
outgoing, and
where's
his profit?
There's a massive difference.
Yeah, there is. And once he's had his tax bill, like you're saying, paid his VAT and everything else, what's left?
It just annoys me where he keeps saying, you know, other people ain't on Company House. There is absolutely thousands of businesses that have no need to have their information on there.
Yeah.
Limited companies is where if he goes under or anything else, he's not going to be liable.
Yeah.
You know, so to me, he's just a cow and joke.
He is a joke.
That's the sort of person that would go bankrupt, leave a business owing money, and then fire up a new business.
Exactly. Why, if you look into him, he's actually had a few.
Yeah, I'd be
this
interested
last one
to know
has
that,
only
yeah.
actually been going a couple of years.
Mm-hmm. I would be interested in that information, actually.
Yeah.
Just show his history.
It's all very easy to find.
Yeah, I just haven't
You know,
bothered.
And he's saying about people with his address, that's not hard to find.
No.
He's not actually very clever.
it just tries to make out he's some big businessman. He's not. When you're having to flex what you are, I think you're probably nowhere near what you're saying you are.
Well, it's silly because a business is, for first 5 years is when most businesses fail.
Yeah.
You know, so to me, he's shouting his mouth off a bit too soon.
Yeah, absolutely, I agree.
But then equally, I also don't think that people have the right to go to your property.
No, I absolutely agree with you, Charmaine. It should never, ever, this is a fucking app, and there's no way you should be going to anybody's house threatening to come and invade their privacy. It's a fucking app. Deal with it on the app or don't deal with it. You know what I mean?
I agree with that. I agree.
But although he is that annoying, if I wasn't a father or anything, I think I'd have probably been tempted to have a wander down to his house because he is such a fucking annoying little shit.
Well, to be honest, he just keeps doxing himself anyway, so...
I think I would have wanted to confront him if I were a totally single bloke and no responsibilities, because he is an arse. He's an absolute arse.
But then that surely means that you need to take time off the app then, because if you're letting a dweeb like that get to you...
No, so he makes me feel like that sometimes. No, he doesn't all the time. It doesn't... even if I show in a look like as if I'm angry about something, I'm not really that angry deep down because I just can't give a shit about them, to be honest.
Just frustrating, isn't it?
It's frustrating, that's all, yeah. So
I just find him comical.
Morning, Miss B. Yeah, comical, annoying. Yeah. The whole works are there, aren't they? The whole bunch of feelings are there with him. All right, Millsy.
I'm going to drop back down now because I've got some work to do and I'll keep listening.
All right, thanks. All right, I'm going to carry on, Charmaine.
Yep, I'm jumping.
All right, love. Do you want me to drop you?
Yeah, I can't find the button.
Get out.
By the way, as I was just watching,
thank you.
Pausing, stopping my life, your hello hashtag there, Frankie, it doesn't work. It means it's bullshit.
What's this? Angie talks about how she's TikTok tonight. They've removed her hashtag. So if you hashtag her, you've got to be careful as well, because if you hashtag her now, you'll get a violation. Because that hashtag will give you a violation. So there's a few people saying they've had violations because of the hashtag. By using it. So
what? A hashtag. The reason why the hashtag was removed, and I'll tell you why.
Oh, morning, Christine.
Is because of the bullying on my name. Not because I'm bullying other people. Because
she never does that, does she? She never bullies anybody, does she? Oh, you included, Birdie, yeah?
I watch the videos that I'm tagged into because of the hate train people have created on me. Because I reported individuals, and I didn't realise this when I first went live, but I realise now. I report many people on TikTok, right? And I went to TikTok because I've got, and
you
I
didn't
emailed
go to TikTok.
Them with videos,
no, you, no,
after
you didn't.
Videos after videos.
Can I just remind you all, she's got no connection to TikTok, no more than what you've got. That's absolute bullshit.
So I assume they removed the hashtag so I didn't see the hate against me. Because that does nothing to me. That's nothing to do with me. It's not because I'm bullying anyone.
Famous
it's
darling.
Because of people putting up videos in regards to me, hating on me, hate campaign against me, it's so I don't see it. And, and that's what I've got messages after messages people telling me on my WhatsApp. So that does kind of make sense. Because, bullying can be, bullying on...
It's our pages that have had it removed because of our content and then getting removed. Ah, right, okay, yeah. She's,
Social media can be horrendous, right? So that's why, because it didn't make sense to me. Why would you remove the hashtag? It didn't make sense. Because all it is I can't see their videos, but you can still see my videos. But it didn't make sense. But now it makes sense. It's because of the hate campaign against me on social media.
The hate campaign against her. This is what really gets my goat. Nobody created anything against you. You created it your bloody self. Seriously.
You can see the hate and the bullying that I'm receiving because of many people that have unalived themselves on social media. So big up TikTok for that. And I'm glad they have done that because that makes sense to me.
She always cries the victim when she does something. This is how I see it, right? She does something to create drama because she wants to be on the FYP, right? So once she's on the FYP, she thinks it should stay on the FYP. It's just nobody should report on it, nobody should talk about it, nobody should be doing anything. So when the drama comes back to her, because other people then are talking about it and discussing it and saying, well, we don't agree with this and we're not agreeing with that, she doesn't like it. It's suddenly now she's a victim. No, you're not. You're a victim of your own actions. That's all it is. You are a victim of your own actions. Don't do the action, you will not be victimised by it, will you? And that's all anybody's ever said to you. Stop your shit, you won't get no shit. And that's exactly how it works.
But people have seen it in a different light. Hey, really? They've seen it as in,
hello.
I'm the bully. No, if I'm the bully, why am I not seeing their videos? You shouldn't be seeing my videos, right? You shouldn't be seeing my live. You shouldn't be seeing my videos if I'm the bully. But it's the other way around. I'm not seeing their videos.
Again, if you didn't do it, we wouldn't see it. If we didn't see it, we wouldn't act on it. If we didn't act on it, you wouldn't react to it.
That does not make sense. It doesn't matter to me that I don't see their videos. Do you understand? It does not make sense.
I don't see yours unless somebody tags me in it. And do you know what? They only tag me in it because we've seen it. What the fuck are you talking about?
I don't care,
woman?
If I don't see their videos because it's all hate. And that's what TikTok has done. Because many people,
Milsey, thank you.
Not
Kerry,
just
Hazel,
me, but other
Akilia,
people.
Michelle. Oh shit! Sorry, I scrolled out. Oops.
I'm quite happy. It's because of people putting up videos in regards to me, hating on me, hate campaign against me, and so I don't see it. And yeah, and that's what I've got messages after messages, people telling me on my WhatsApp. So that does kind of make sense. Because, you know, bullying can be, you know, bullying on social media can be horrendous, right?
Oh, shut up.
So that's why, because it didn't make sense to me. Why would you remove the hashtag? It didn't make sense.
Who cares?
Because all it is I can't see their videos, but you can still see my videos.
The only person I think she's talking to there is herself. She's trying to convince herself of something, because it ain't convincing nobody else.
It didn't make sense, but now it makes sense. It's because of the hate campaign against me on social media. They don't want me to see the hate and the bullying that I'm receiving because of many people that have unalived themselves on social media. Oh, so big up TikTok for that.
Do you know what? She's pushing this a lot. I'll tell you what, I've seen this now for quite a while. She's pushing this unaliving. And it wouldn't surprise me, and I'll say it right here and now, it wouldn't surprise me if this fool here does something to trigger the fucking whole app. I'm telling you now, because that's the sort of manipulative thing it is. It wouldn't surprise me if she attempts to do something, not actually do it, but make it look like she's done something to trigger every fucker. So that she can throw it back in the faces. Honestly, it's coming, I'm telling you. And then blame
and
everybody else.
I have done that because that makes sense to me.
If you didn't do what you do, it won't be seen, but she's good at putting the blame on manipulation. If you don't, I don't understand what that means. You said it to your husband last night. Yeah, I do, Lucy. I honestly think that's where it's going.
But people have seen it in a different light. They've seen it as in that I'm the bully. No, if I'm the bully, why am I?
It's all about bully. She turns out, oh, you're all bullying me. You're all bullying me. You're all bullying me. I'm drinking a little bit more. I'm drinking more. I'm doing more and more and more. And this talk of, she did a video. We played it a couple of days ago. The talk about, what if I SH? What if I do this? What if I do this? Talking about people that have actually done it as well. I think she's preparing herself to get you all triggered.
I'm seeing their videos. You shouldn't be seeing my videos, right? You shouldn't be seeing my live. You shouldn't be seeing my videos if I'm the bully. But it's the other way around. I'm not seeing their videos.
I'm not talking about a random two falling out. Ash, that's not fair. Remember, I don't want mine to fall out. Can wobble this morning.
That does not make sense.
Quite agree, Robert.
It doesn't matter to me that I don't see their videos. Do you understand? It does not make sense. That I don't care if I don't see their videos because it's all hate. And that's what TikTok has done.
Yeah, she is psycho warrior. She's very good at turning it around. And like I said, it's all a game to her. She knows exactly from start to finish what she's doing. She knows what she's doing. And she knows that people are going to get triggered. She knows she's going to upset people. And she wants the replies back and she wants the drama back to keep it going because she's all about the numbers. She's all about getting the gifts in and the numbers. Making herself all over the FYP. Making her think she's number one on the app. I'd rather be nothing on this app than have this sort of clout, this negative shit. Honestly, I'd rather be a nobody.
Many people, not just me, but other people, probably including the police, to be honest, have reported to TikTok. Because I have made many reports on TikTok to the police, right? So it does make sense that my hashtag would be removed. And that's because, so I don't see the hate against me.
Yeah, me neither.
So it does make sense.
Look, you know what, when you actually, look, when you're looking at these videos, right, and you watch her talking, look at her face. I know that hurts, but look at her face. You can see the smirk behind the eyes, in the lips. You can see the smirks and the cockiness. Do you know what I mean? You just got to watch her, what they call it, mannerisms or whatever it is you call it. Just watch closer.
But you can look at it. You can look at it. But look at it as however you want to look at it.
Mm-hmm. So you asked about Ailey. We don't know. All we know, all that I've been told so far, is over the last few weeks, maybe a month or so, is this Ailey was accused, or has been accused, that she's been stealing money from a pensioner, or grandma, or something with dementia, and she's been stealing money. Whether that's true or not, nobody can prove it because there's been no proof. But she has deactivated her accounts, apparently. I haven't checked.
Because, listen, you've got to remember my hashtag has been removed because, not because I'm bullying, I'm not seeing their videos, but you're still seeing my videos. So if I'm the bully, make it make sense. If I'm the bully, yeah, if I'm the bully, they would permanently banana me. I'd be removed.
Well, that might be coming, you never know. I'm sure she's had it, and she had a couple of accounts permanently bananaed already. And I say, if your hashtag's actually been removed and people are putting pressure on TikTok, then it won't be long before you are getting bananaed.
From social media, I've not been removed.
No sympathy for us. Yeah, I know. Right? Yeah, sorry.
So what they've done is remove the hashtag. What means is that I can't see their hashtag. When people are sharing me videos, it's usually hate videos. That's the videos.
Oh, her husband and her kids picked names and added. Was supposed to. Is this Haley on about Sour?
I'm getting, and it's based on hate. Those videos to TikTok. Do you understand? I've been sending those videos to TikTok, so they remove my hashtag, right. So I don't get those kind of videos. So they're helping me. They're not helping you. Yes. Otherwise, it doesn't make sense.
Right. I watched EQ for a week or so now. And it was EQ doxed it. People have said it yesterday too. Right, okay.
You know, stop me from hashtag me. It doesn't make sense from seeing your videos. No, you want to stop yourself from getting my videos if I'm a bully, right? Make it make sense.
Yeah, me too, Amy.
Like, you don't understand the will.
This guy. I never know what to make of this guy. I swear to God.
Power that I have inside me to not stamp all over your face. And,
Does anybody know who he's talking about here? Because I was picking up that he's talking about.
Honest, I messaged her a minute ago. I said, you're banned from my.
A woman. He's talking like that. Just listen to that again. He's talking about, is it his ex he's talking about, or his ex-girlfriend or whatever?
All over your face. And, I messaged her a minute ago. I said, you're banned from my house.
This is, what he says in here can be triggering to people. So, you know, I do have the trigger warning permanently up there because everything we play may have a trigger in it. But yeah, I just warn you, this might. Thinking of what he says, so.
I said, you won't come here for another month. Another month. I said, you're taking a piss, bruv. You're fucking taking a piss, mate. Because what'll happen is I'll end up in jail all my life. It will end up me being very physically violent towards her, like stamping on her, punching her face in, fucking slamming her, bruv. Fucking weighing her in, bruv, yeah?
Just why would a fucking man come on an app and say this sort of shit? Why? What does he think he's gaining from this?
And I'm just like, you're so lucky, you're fucking lucky, mate. But yeah, that was mine last night. That was mine last night, yeah. You'd hit a woman. If I lost my fucking temper, of course I would, brother. Are you
Because you ain't no fucking man, are you? You ain't no fucking man. You little pussy ass. That's what you are.
Fucking mental.
I don't care if I get a band
for it. I lose my temper and you keep pushing and you keep pushing and you keep pushing and you keep pushing and you keep pushing, there's only...
What a fucking hero you are.
Only one or two things to do. Phone the police, drag you out the house, or battle the life out of you.
How about I take you down a dark alley and sort you out? How's that? Right, because I promise you now, if I hear on this app that you've actually done something like that, I'm gonna come down to Brighton. I'm gonna fucking find you and I'm gonna batter you. How's that?
Or drop you home. I'm lucky that so far.
We can all do that, can't we? Can't we? Because you're a nobody, mate.
I've never hit a woman. But brother, if they push me that much.
And I don't believe you now. You just said what you'd do to your ex. Okay? You're ranting on here, acting the fucking big I am. You're on here. You reckon you'd do that to your ex, so I reckon I'll call that you've actually done it to somebody. Because that's just what you are.
Fucking switch.
Fuck off, you haven't got schizophrenia at all, you lying bastard.
It's your fault, not mine. I warn you. I tell people, know about me. I'm not
a lying bastard. Oh, I've got schizophrenia, so that gives me an excuse. Go fuck yourself. How's that? You big pussyhole. I'm going to say pussyhole to these people.
I'm schizophrenic. Don't fucking push the boat that far away.
What a pleb.
Don't do it, because you'll be in danger. And people need to realise, I ain't got the same brain as you. I am.
Oh, really?
And so far in my life, I've been so well with it, I've been so good with it. I've never hit a woman, I've never hit a child, I've never gone after an old person, because I don't put myself around situations where I have to do that. But she recently...
Oh, what the fuck? So he's saying if he was in a situation, he'd do it to every one of them that he's just mentioned. You're a fucking ass, mate. Absolute ass.
And he's taking a fucking piss, bro. Waking me up at 3:30, 2:00 till 3:00, chatting shit. Nah, she's lucky, bro. I'll be so real with her. I'll be fucking real with anyone that wants it. I'll be so real, bro. If it was a geezer, if it was anyone else, I wouldn't drop them home. I'd smash their face in.
No, you won't. And next time I'm down in Brighton, I'll call you. How's that?
Damp on them 100 times. And that's all my child's life. Like, you don't understand the...
I mean by...
Utter scumbag. How's that? That's what you are, mate. Scumbag.
That is. I'll always back someone, yeah, like Gypsy Queen. Okay, she might have said a racist comment, right?
Oh, no, wait, hold on. I've just been sent...
And men as in regards to a child.
Do and family, San, hope they all get ill. Did you say that to Top Girl?
What?
Did you say that to Top Girl?
Say that again.
Angie went for Top Girl Kid 2 and Family Sound.
No, I said her parents, yeah.
Still talking about kids though, Angie.
I stand by them.
Still talking about kids.
No, that's not
true. So you're just
parents.
As bad then? You're just as bad?
No, Melon, I
you're
spoke
just as bad
parents.
Then? What right have you got to
parents.
Talk, Angie? Have you got any kids,
no.
Angie?
Melon, why are you turning on me like this?
I'm saying the truth. Have you got any
no,
kids,
I'm
Angie?
No, but you're asking me to apply, but won't let
you
me reply.
You just said, one, you'd always support a racist, and now I'm asking your question. You're trying
you
to
won't let me reply to you. I was talking about Top Girl's parents, and I stand with that chest. Because you know why? She slagged me off, yeah, my mother's in hospital, and thought it was okay to send me a little message saying, I hope your mother's okay, but then continued slagging me off. That, to me, you're going to get tenfold. You're going to get karma on you. And your family, not your children, your family, your parents.
I could go to Arshad. You're an old woman, innit? So.
I'll stand with it. I'll stand what I say.
Hello.
In regards to Gypsy Queen, I didn't mean I'll stand by racist. I mean as in that, yes, okay, she's been racist, but I will stand...
Alicia, I don't know what to say. Because anything that comes out of this thing's mouth anymore, I don't believe a fucking thing that comes out of it. When I said I've washed my hands of it.
Stand by her, because she went for a child. That's what I meant.
If Corey wore a wig.
This app is pathetic, mate.
This
app.
Allowing Corey to come in, this is not your...
And make out the my martyr, because Top Girl sent me a message saying, I hope your mother's okay, and then sit there and slag me off when I'm going through fucking stress in regards to my mother in hospital.
And there it is! There it is! That's all she's done since her mum went into hospital. Throw a load of shit out and go, well, if you're bullying me, you know you don't care because my mum's in hospital. Stop using your mum as an excuse, you pathetic, ranting old cow.
But parents, Top Girl. Ban your fucking parents. How about that?
Angie, do me a favour. Do you want to drop it?
The hell? What was that about? Jesus, wet.
No, I just say that. Use your word.
Get the word
out. I don't care, no, Corey.
Get the word. Fucking Jesus. The youth of today.
Stop letting him antagonise you then, because that's what he's doing. He's antagonising you, that's what he's doing.
Her parents, yeah? Her parents are going to go what my mother's going to, yeah?
Let's have a party!
And I'm going to see and slag
Let's have a party!
Well, I'm not a keen fan, I am not a fan of Mylands, but that's funny.
Hospital, but she's
Angie,
up to me.
Angie,
and then
Angie.
I'll send her a message saying, oh, I know we're going through beef, Top Girl, but I hope your mother's okay. But then sit in Miss Red's live and slag me off. No, it doesn't work like that. You erase that message.
Right, let's move on now, yeah?
Yes.
Disappointed in you, Angela.
I don't give any fucks. I think I'm going enough for my mum. I feel I need to unblock EQ just to say thank you for the views that she's given me. With
For fuck's sake. I'm going to have to restart, guys. Won't be a second. I'll just restart. Better ask me.